Hello everybody, welcome back. Thanks again for tuning in on my channel. Here you see my T5 locomotive. It's a locomotive I bought last week on a train show. And well, it's a good locomotive, it runs, but it doesn't run as smooth as we are used to from a lok these days. And this is because this is an old lok. It was built in the late 90s and it contains a delta decoder, which was actually sort of the first sort of digital decoder on the market. With these decoders you could run four trains no less on a single track, which of course was in the 90s a huge step forward. But as I turn up the throttle you can hear it buzzing and you don't see it moving. Listen very carefully. You hear that? Now it starts to move very slowly in a sort of shocking way. So let's try to change that. I will change the decoder, do some alterations on the engine, and let's see what happens. So yeah, follow me to the workbench. So first of all, we have to open the locomotive. We do that by taking this cap off. There's a screw underneath. And if that screw is loose, then we can take the whole bodywork off and then we can work on the engine. So there we are, the cap is off. You see there's a screw in here. So the screw is loose and now we can take off the bodywork. And there we are. So there you see the old delta decoder. We're going to take that one out and place a new digital decoder. And here you see the engine, and a prominent feature of this engine is of course this big spool. This is an AC engine, which means that this magnet changes polarity all the time because it is an AC magnet, AC engine. Now we have to change that in order to make it work correctly with the new decoder. So we're going to open up the engine and place a magnet that is constant, so that doesn't change polarity all the time. So this is the Lokpilot that we're going to install. It's a Lokpilot 5 Basic. You can see it here. It's made by ESU and it's a fairly cheap standard decoder. I paid, I think, $28 for it. So it's not that expensive. It doesn't have a lot of functions, but I only want to drive and switch the lights on and off. So that's enough for me. Now then, for the engine, I've bought this kit. It's a Märklin kit 60941. So if we open it up, we see that we've got a new cap for the motor. We see the permanent magnet that we will install. There's some small parts here. And this is interesting because this is a motor that has 5 spools, you see. I think if we open this one up, that there will be a motor in it with 3 spools. And I'm not very confident if this one will fit. Last time I tried this with a different locomotive, it didn't quite fit. So, well, we'll see. If it fits, we'll throw it in. If it doesn't fit, we keep the 3-polic motor. So to pull this out, I just have to snap this little click system that is here. But unfortunately, I just cut my fingernails, so it... There you see, it gets loose. That's one. Yeah. So you see, all comes off at once. There's the screw. All right. And this is what I meant. This is an engine that has, this is a motor that has three spools. Now let's carefully cut some wires. So let's try to install the new magnet. It just clicks in place, so that's good news. And then let's try the motor with 5 spools. And this seems to fit, which is good news. I had another loco where it wouldn't fit, so this is good news. If I turn it, the wheels turn, yeah. That's good news. And then we'll place the new lid on it, which way is up? This way is up, so I'll just place it over it. And then some screws, this one here. And there's supposed to be another one. Yep. Now, and this is supposed to work just fine. There's one thing we have to do. So here's the brushes that transmit the power to the engine. And these are very small parts. You can see there's a small notch here, and this is meant to catch the copper wire. So there will be a copper wire here that sort of forms a spring and pushes the brush inside. So this goes in here. It's important to have this notch on the outside. If you can see it there. Yeah. And now I can bring this back. In such a way that it falls into this notch and pushes it against the drive work of the motor. So that's one side done. The other side as well. So I forgot this part. It has to go under one of the screws. And that's the rebuild of the motor. So I've printed a sort of conversion table for the wire colors that Märklin uses and that ESU uses. So time to get out the solder iron and get to work. Now this has to be soldered to this piece of copper, you see? And the other one on this piece of copper. So yeah, let's give it a try. Let's put some solder on the iron. There we are. And this is awkward. So there we are, they are nice and firm. So orange and gray are for the motor. Red and black are for the current to the track. And white and yellow are for the front and the backlight. There we go. Let's put the shrink tube in place. There we are. Now to check if all our efforts have made a difference, I want to test it. I'm going to increase the throttle with one notch and see what happens. It starts to crawl immediately, there's no humming, and it runs quite smooth. So I think mission accomplished.